If you are developing any product in SolidWorks, then it's going to have the obvious CAD data. However, the project will also need to contain a lot more useful information as well. Details like who created the model, what is it made from, how much does it weigh, do we need to buy it in or get it manufactured? Now, the best way to handle all this additional information is to add custom properties to your files. If you want to sound geeky, then we call this information metadata. The most obvious use of this data is to help complete your drawing title blocks, something that you really shouldn't be doing manually as it is time consuming, prone to mistakes, and is also just plain boring. You might also want to introduce some consistency within your company, making sure everyone uses the same terminology. In this example for material, do we want the note to use the grade of aluminium or just plain aluminium? We could just be trying to avoid basic spelling mistakes like aluminum or aluminium. All joking aside, this does become very important as you want to use this information for more than just drawing borders. Custom properties don't just live in a title block, but are individual attributes attached to a file. So now we can search for more than just a file name, but any of these attributes or combinations of these attributes. Now, if you're using the 3D Experience platform, then this becomes very important and very powerful and very useful, but only if you have consistency. What do I mean by that? Well, if we search for alloy within our projects, then we might get one set of results. But if we search for 6061 aluminium, then we're going to get a different set of results. Something that can be avoided if we had consistency within the design team and is easily done when you use the property tab. Okay, we have explained the problem. Now let's show you the solution. I'm going to use the property tab to add some details to my trusty tool chest. Well, the handle to begin with. The custom property tab is in the side task pane area. And once activated, we can see a form that has been created to help add technical details to my part. In this example, I might want to add a part number, update the manufacturing process, and add my name to the file. This is done by simply clicking on the drop-downs and picking the required option. You must click Apply to add these properties to the file. So what has this done? Well, if we look in the file properties, then we can see the information has been added to that file. Again, these are the details that you should be using to fill out your drawing title blocks or add extra depth to your bills of materials. So this is our custom property tab. Yours will be blank. So let's show you how to build one. The property tab is not built within SolidWorks itself. Instead, it has its own tool called, surprisingly, the Property Tab Builder. You can access it either by the template options or search for it within your Windows applications. You will find it in the SolidWorks Tools area. The Property Tab Builder is a fairly easy tool to use. We have three main areas. The left-hand pane is your tools. The center pane is your property tab that you're building. And the right-hand pane is where you adjust any attributes. Now, typically, you're going to create three different property tabs. One for parts, one for assemblies, and one for drawings. This is where you start, by specifying what tab this is going to be used for. And I normally start with a part. Your center pane will already have a group box waiting for you, and you use group boxes to collate certain data together. So in this case, we might want to add all the project information together in one group box. I will rename this group box to display our company name, so TriMech. I am going to add a description property. Now this is going to be different every time I use it. So the best tool to use would be a text box, which I can just drag across into the center pane. Please note the controls must go inside a group box. Now we can customize this control. So let's change its caption to description. Now this is purely the text we see in the property tab pane. What we now need to do is assign it to an actual custom property using the drop-down list assigned to the name. Now there's already exists a property for description, so I'll select that from the list. And that's it. That's our first control created. Now a second control might want to be who created this model. If you have several designers within your company, then we're not going to want to keep typing in our names manually. So instead, a list would be useful. So we can drag over a list control into our center pane placing it inside our TriMech Group box and below the description. We want to change the caption to Drawn By and pick another custom property. You will find Drawn By in the list again by default. We can create a quick, simple list here by simply filling in the rows. And you can have more than four rows, just keep hitting enter to add another one. There is also an option here to allow custom values. Or in other words, I could just type in another random name into this box whilst using it within SolidWorks. Now that would be useful for some custom properties, but not necessarily for colleagues' names. Now this list of names might be useful again and again. Certainly we're going to use it within an assembly version of the property tab, or to perhaps have it as an approved by list in a drawing tab. I don't want to have to keep typing 20 names over and over again. So instead of manually doing that, I can populate this list from an existing text file or an Excel spreadsheet. Something that I would highly recommend doing for lots of any kind of list-based applications. Now it just so happens that I have a list of names in a notepad file, so we can just link this property to that file, and then that will populate our list for us. We'll add one final property, a drawn date. This will be another text box again, and we'll change the caption and link it to the drawn date property. But this time the type will be date. This will give us a really nice calendar tool, but we won't be able to see that until we use it within SolidWorks. So let's save our work so far. This property tab needs to go into a set location so that SolidWorks can find it. Now we recommend that if you customize anything in SolidWorks, that it does not want to be saved in the default location, which will be something like C, program data, SolidWorks, SolidWorks 2023, /language, etc. You want to save it in a safe location, and then you tell SolidWorks where that file is saved. In my case, anything I have customized is saved on my C drive in the SolidWorks standard data folder. I have then mapped this location within the SolidWorks options under file locations and custom property files, which is where SolidWorks is expected to find our property tabs. Once this has been set, then your property tab will appear. Or in my case, I need to swap from my current one to this new temporary one that we've been working on. And then you can see the list of names that's been generated from that notepad, and you can see the drawn date tool. Now we might want to add more custom properties to our property tab, and the tab builder also has some great tools hidden up its sleeve. Generally, you tend to model two types of physical product, something that you're going to get custom made for your project and something that you buy off the shelf, such as a motor, a switch, or a bearing, for example. Now the information that you'd want on your design components would typically be different from that you buy in. Our parts might require material, finish, manufacturing process, whereas the purchase parts would have their supplier name, supplier part number. So let's add these details to our property tab. I'm going to add a new group box and rename that to Make. We'll add a text box and rename that to Material, again linking the property to Material. However, this time, instead of having to type in the material, we're going to link it to a value created by SolidWorks, called, selecting our usual way within SolidWorks, to our custom property. Now, material finishes is a separate thing to material, and it has repeatable options. So a list tool would be a great tool to use. So we're going to drag in a list, rename that to finish, link to finish property, and populate that list with an existing notepad list of different material finishes. One final property for our made parts, and that's going to be the weight. Now, similar to the material, this is something I don't want to have to type in manually, but it would be nice to see it in our property tab. This is going to be a text box, renamed and linked to the weight property, but the value is going to be SW mass, the SolidWorks weight. And that would be our part properties done. Again, I'm going to start with a group box and rename that to buy. Now the first property would be the supplier name. For a lot of companies, there would be a regular suppliers, so a list is going to be useful, and we will rename the caption to supplier. However, if we look in the property list, there's no supplier option. So there's two solutions to this. One is just to choose a property that is similar, so source or vendor maybe. The other option is that this list of properties is actually just a text file that exists in your SolidWorks install location /lang/English. Or in my case, it exists in my safe area. And you can add another property to that list, and then that would appear in your choice of options. I'm going to populate this supplier list with an existing list of suppliers from a text list. However, I will tick the option here to allow custom values. So I could type a new supplier name that isn't on that list, who's just a kind of a one-off. Part number is going to be different every time, different from supplier to supplier. So similar to the description, we'll just use a text box and link that to a part number. Now I like to keep things tidy. If this is a made part, then I don't want to see information about brought parts, and vice versa. Well, we can do that using a radio button. Now I'm going to drag this into the top TriMech group box, and the reason for this will become clear in a moment. Let's rename this to make or buy, and link this to a property of make buy. Now this is a useful attribute in its own right, to be able to search through our assemblies and just select all the made parts or all the brought parts with a couple of clicks. Now you can have more than two buttons, but we're going to keep it simple and rename them to make or buy. And we'll keep the default values the same. So that's what will appear in our custom property. In the advanced options, we can select the make group box for our make button and our buy group box for our buy button. Okay, let's update this tab, save it and return to SolidWorks and see it in action. To see the updated property tab, then we need to hit F5 to refresh it. Currently, the Make Radio button is selected, so we can only see the options required for manufactured parts. Now we link the material to the SolidWorks material, so it shows us the same selection as if we were using the regular tool, and hence just my regular favourites. So I can add plain carbon steel here, or change my material from within the feature tree and use that of alloy steel. And that change is affected immediately within the property tab. We need to add a finish, so we can select that from our drop-down list, which is populated from our text file, and I'll choose anodized. Finally, we can see that the weight is already added, and this is a great reference, but also an important custom property for most designs. If we select the buy radio button, then our make group box disappears, and our buy options appear instead. So we can choose our supplier from our pre-populated list or add a custom one on the fly by just typing the name. We can then give it a unique part number that is going to be helpful for when we order our components. So whether this is made or brought, when you have finished typing in all the information, you must hit apply to add this information back into the custom properties. At the start of this presentation, I mentioned that you would probably have three different property tabs: part, assembly, and drawings. Well, the part and assembly one would be very similar, so I'm going to show you how to create the assembly version from the part version. Back into the property tab builder, and you need to select within the center pane, but not on any of the group boxes. This will pop up the control attribute for the entire property tab, where you can select assembly from the type list. This will now be saved as an assembly property tab. Now most of the information is going to stay the same: description, drawn by, drawn date, etc. However, details like material and finish do not make sense as they're described at the part level. So I typically delete these properties and recreate them, but instead of using lists, I will use a simple text box and I will pre-fill the value with a note such as see part details, or not applicable, or NA. The reason for this is when we're going to link these custom properties to details in, say, a drawing or in a bill of materials, I'd rather have a note with a suitable message rather than a blank space. Now don't forget, these notes still need to be linked to their appropriate custom property, so in other words, material and say finish. This isn't the focus of this video, but I think it's worth just showing the outcome of all this work. So let's create a drawing for our handle, and because the title block has already got the links in it to our custom properties, then that is automatically filled in with the information based on the details we added in our custom property tab. To link any note to a custom property, you use the Link to Property button. Now, within a drawing, you can then decide whether the information has come from the drawing properties themselves or from a model within the drawing. You'll be shown a list of the properties available, and you just need to decide which one, such as description in this case. For more information on creating and customizing drawing templates, then make sure you check out our other videos on that topic. I'm going to create a drawing specific property tab, as generally I don't tend to use one, as I like to control the flow of information from the parts and assemblies. However, if your drawing boarder wanted information like checked by or approved by an approved date, etc., then you might want them to be created within the drawing, so therefore you would create a drawing property tab just with that information, and then that could be linked through to the properties.